surprise hit of 1980 that led to the creation of an entirely new genre of film, Airplane, began a streak of now cult classics, including Top Secret, Ruthless People, the Naked Gun series, and much more. And the man behind it all, writer, director, producer David Zucker, is here. How are you?
I'm good. I'm glad to be here.
I watched that movie 25 times that summer that came out. What was the reaction when it, I mean, for me, it was great, but what was the reaction? It was so different.
Well, it was amazing because, you know, there had never been anything like it. And it was very difficult to get it made because, you know, every studio turned it down because they, what do you want? Let me get this straight. You want to do a comedy without comedians? And that was a pretty new thing then. And so we said, yes, we think Robert Stack is funny and Leslie Nielsen. And I mean, our casting director was tearing out his hair. He said, Leslie Nielsen? Leslie Nielsen's the guy you cast the night before. And we were already, you know, 6 weeks out from photography.
And who would have thought Leslie, I mean, the Naked Gun series, it's like he's made for these roles. Well, and what did you see that other people weren't seeing there?
Well, we used to watch old movies, old, you know, B movies, and think those were funny, not comedies. And we would redub them. You know, there were scenes where the guy would said, what time is 0 hour to launch the missile or something? And the guy would say, you know, 12 midnight. And we would have the guy say, we would dub, where is your hand? It's right here at the end of the wrist. You know, stuff like that. And it was just the most crazy stuff. So the whole concept with Airplane was that we saw this old movie called Zero Hour.
Yeah.
And it was a black and white movie, 1957, with Dana Andrews, Linda Darnell, and Sterling Hayden. Wow. And it actually had the same plot. An airliner goes up. It was a propeller plane in 1957. Yeah. And the pilots got food poisoning. And a guy with PTSD had to fly down the plane. And so it was almost like we were redubbing it. So that was the concept that we actually recast it with Robert Stack, Leslie Nielsen, Peter Graves, and Lloyd Bridges. And they would be, you know, saying the lines very hard hitting, you know, I am serious and don't call me Shirley, you know, that stuff. And so that's why it was funnier if they said it that way than whoever the comics of the day were.
Right.
And so I think all of these hold up, and you could do an Airplane 5, you could do it in a firehouse, you could do it. Why don't we?
Well, we didn't want to do Airplane 2, and we didn't do Airplane 2 because we thought that Airplane was just a specific genre, mm-hmm. a specific movie. But the Naked Guns, you know, we could do any amount of. So, you know, when we have a script of something that is similar to that.
Yeah.
And I think about you getting like a Kareem Abdul-Jabbar to be in that first movie. It's not like you guys had a track record of all these movies and he's sitting as the co-pilot.
Well, yeah, it was great. But in Zero Hour, there was an athlete who actually was a star at the University of Wisconsin and for the LA Rams named Crazy Legs Hirsch. And he played in this 1957 movie, he played the co-pilot.
Or the pilot.
Yeah.
Now, what did your kids think of the movie when they first saw it?
Oh, you know, they loved it. Well, you know, I think I showed my son Charles Airplane, you know, when he was two or one and a half. I mean, you know, that's, you know, we're just watching it, and it was pretty good. He didn't understand.
Well, there were a couple of scenes that probably went over his head.
I know.
But
his favorite scene was the boobies.
Okay.
And in fact, so after that, we started watching a lot of softcore porn together. I like the stuff, but he saw it as food. You know.
Boy, softcore porn and Airplane together, you could do, there are so many ways to go with that.
I picked the wrong week to stop watching this stuff. But that was actually a straight line in Zero Hour. He said, I picked the wrong week to quit drinking.
So what do you got coming up next? What can we see coming up from you?
Well, I've got two movie scripts that are just, I think, are fabulous. I just have to make the studios believe that they're fabulous.
You have to sell stuff after all this time.
I have to sell stuff, because what I do isn't, what they want is what they've already been doing, and I always want to do something new, like, you know, back in when we did Airplane. And then I'm also creating a company to creating content for the digital space. And as soon as I find out what the digital space is, then I'll be able to elaborate on that.
Well, it's so great to meet you.
Likewise.
And you can find David on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And you're traveling up to University of Wisconsin.
Yes,
your alma mater.
I'm going to pick up my son at UW. He just completed his freshman year.
Oh, well, it's great to see you. Thanks for being here.
Sure.
Hey, Paul.
My pleasure.